Hey guys, welcome back to our channel Naughty Vlogs. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and also hit the bell icon to get the future notifications. So today's video is about Cooper's grooming session. We took him to Wagging Tails. I am a regular visitor there. This is I think fourth or the fifth time I am taking him to this place ever since I got him. He's around 8 months old now. So I took him for his haircut and body wash. So look at him. He's so fussy. He already knows he's going to be in trouble. So he's extremely nervous now. He always takes time when he's in a new place or when he is with someone he doesn't know. And there he is hiding under the table. We always give him some time to get used to the place so that he doesn't panic. So here's the guy who usually does the grooming. Even though Cooper knows him, he always takes time. So the guys there are really good at their work. They know how to handle the pets. He always takes him for a walk, tries to, you know, make friends with him every single time we go there. So finally, after 15 to 20 minutes, Cooper is finally on the table here, waiting to get washed. He is so scared of heights. He is generally very naughty, he is very playful, but in this place he is very, very nervous. So he's all getting ready for the wash. I think he's so nervous that he peed on the table. Because he knows what exactly is going to happen now. He doesn't like taking shower at all. We always bribe him if I have to wash him at home. So he's washing Cooper. And for a change, he is being a really good boy because he never does this at home. so he's almost done. They usually leave him with the conditioner for about 10 minutes because he has long hair. I was really surprised to see him like this because if I have to wash him, it's a big circus at home. He is all over the place and he never is this good boy. He's getting everything done so nicely today. So he's done with his shower. Now is the drying time. So this is the most challenging part always because he just hates anything that is loud. So the blower sound makes him extremely nervous. Even at home, if I have to use a hairdryer, he is extremely nervous and he just doesn't stop barking. So let's see what he does today. They usually use a towel to pat him dry before they use the blower because that's how I have requested them to use as less blower as possible because he just doesn't like it. He is super confused now. I sometimes wonder what might be going on in his head. Maybe he just wants to get done as early as possible and rush home. So this place is called Wagging Tails. I think they have branches as well. The one I visited was very close to my place where I stay. If you guys want, I can leave all the details in the description box and you can check it out. It's a very nice place for the pets. People there are very friendly. You can also leave your pets overnight just in case if you're traveling and you don't have anybody to look after your pets. They have that service as well. So that's how they dry him usually because he has a very long hair. It takes time. It takes almost 20 to 25 minutes for him to be totally dry. Because once he's dry, we also have to get his hair trimmed because his eyes are almost covered right now. So here at this stage he's almost dry, just I think maybe a minute or two. He just has to get his face. He's trying his best to escape. So once he's completely dry, they brush him before they actually start trimming the hair. This time I didn't want any of his hair on the top of his body to be shortened. I just wanted the hair around his eyes to be trimmed because it was all falling on his eyes and he was not able to see properly. And it's also difficult to keep him clean if he has lot of hair around his eyes. And I also got his nails clipped and the hair on his chest and stomach area removed. I usually get a poodle cut done for him so that he has very less hair on his, around his paws. Because we keep washing the paws almost every other day. Because he climbs our bed, he is on the sofa, he is all over the place except the kitchen. My mom has trained him in such a way that he doesn't enter the kitchen because he has a lot of hair and we don't want his hair, on our plates and food. So this is the first time I think he's getting everything done so nicely. So he's got his first leg done. I think last time when I got him to this place, it was two and a half months ago. We actually got him completely shaved, with as in the zero blade shave. I was told that it is good to get it done after he is 6 months old. So I got it done, and after about 2 to 2.5 months, he already has all his hair back. It's a very difficult task to maintain if he has a very long hair. We have to comb him or brush him about 2 to 3 times a day. That's the minimum. Otherwise, it tends to get matted, and then it's very difficult. It's very painful for them as well. So I prefer keeping the hair short so that it is easy to manage, and he dries sooner when we wash him. I generally wash him once a week, or if he starts stinking, then maybe much earlier than a week. He's otherwise a really clean boy. He is trained. He doesn't dirty anywhere except in the bathroom. Even if he wants to pee, he goes to the bathroom and he pees. That's how we have trained him. Even if he's locked inside the cage, he starts to, he starts making weird noise. So then we know that, he has to pee or do something. And then once we let him free, he's right there in the bathroom. So here is getting his nails clipped. He is used to this because whenever I take him for a general checkup to his vet, I get it done. Otherwise, you know, it's really painful when he is in our hands or when we are carrying him. He sometimes tends to scratch, so I always get the nails trimmed. I also asked him to trim his chest area because it's very difficult to brush him underneath there and he tends to get matted. So that's what he'll be doing now. So like a good boy, he's standing up and he's getting it all done. I'm really, really surprised. Because he's never this calm when he is at this place. So it's always good to shave this part because they like it cool. Now it's time to get the face done. I usually tie his hair up on his head, but right now it's too small, so I'm not going to shorten the hair on his head, just going to trim around the eyes so that he can see properly. is done with his haircut. This is the final blow so that all the loose hair on his body comes off, and he hates it like always. He just has to get his ears clean now, and then I guess we are done. He is so happy once he sees the ribbon, because he knows once everything is done, they usually tie a ribbon before they send him home. So this is his happy moment, or the moment of joy, I can tell you. That's a really sweet gesture. They tie a ribbon every time around his neck once he's done. So look at him. He is so cute. So finally we are done, and now we are heading back home. He looks extremely cute and I just can't stay away from him. So I hope you guys like this video of Cooper getting groomed. Don't forget to share your comments in the comment section below. And I guess that's it for today then. Also like, share and subscribe to our channel. And I'll see you soon in my next video. Until then, stay tuned guys. Bye bye and have fun.